Lucas is a 16.2-hand, 17-year-old thoroughbred gelding bred by the Houdins in Riverside, California. His sire is Crystal Waters, and his dam is Paula Revere. He ran in three races as a two-year-old under the track name of Just Ask Mike.
Come back to Just Ask Mike and Sporting Gesture.
He bowed both front tendons during this time, left the racetrack, and changed hands several times over the next 7 years.
Well, I remember looking at Lucas initially, I kind of got the feeling that he just came off the racetrack. He had a swollen tendon that was evidence of probably quite a few races. He was a little bit underweight, not quite the condition that he's in now, obviously, but he looked a little bit kind of worn, a little bit kind of used, kind of got the impression that, you know, maybe he didn't have the best life until Karen got him.
After being rescued from severe neglect, he was rehabilitated and ended up at a jumping stable where he wasn't fitting in. According to the ad in the local newspaper, he was described as a green project horse, kind and sensitive. Well, that was enough for Karen Murdoch to call about him, and it was love at first sight.
I've always been fascinated with the way that animals learn and love being around them. Over the years, I've studied the training of dogs, marine mammals, birds, even zoo animals, and especially horses, particularly dressage, barrel racing, and everything in between, looking for techniques that would work and that I could include in my program. During this time, I developed a system using a combination of shaping, clicker techniques, and positive reinforcement, using my own modifications along the way. This approach uses the fastest, best retained, and most generalized knowledge that I've ever seen.
At 9 years old, Lucas came with and developed an assortment of evasions and resistances that sure had come in very handy over his troubled life. One by one, Karen tackled them by using games and play to replace the old problems with new and fun behaviors designed to improve his focus, trust, and the relationship.
One, two, four, eight, three. Very good.
What touched me most about the story of Karen and Lucas is that Karen had a difficult upbringing, and she felt, that her life was tough, and she had some struggles, and so did Lucas. Lucas was unwanted after his short racetrack experience. So together, Lucas and Karen mirrored each other. They both came from a difficult background to emerge happier and healthier, and together they healed each other. And that was touching for me.
Gradually, Lucas's attitude shifted, and with each passing week, Karen noticed an increase in his eagerness and willingness. Even an intense curiosity and a tentativeness started to surface.
I felt compelled to do this to show the happy results of kind training and to show how wonderful and smart animals are for their improved treatment.
Why, no sooner would Karen arrive at the stables where he was boarded that he would start to nicker and try to engage his new owner in some sort of new game or show off some already learned trick or two. At this point, about a year and a half later, he had learned to bow, kiss, yawn, nod yes, Spanish walk, smile and pose. Karen decided it was time to see just how much he could learn, given the opportunity.
Lucas's training is done entirely at liberty, without the use of any force whatsoever. I don't even own a whip. My primary training tools are love, patience, freedom, and choice.
The discrimination tasks that Lucas understands up to now are letters, numbers, colors, shapes, same, different, proportion, and absentness.
He's an inspiration to all off-the-track horses.
His Liberty repertoire also now includes the jambe, three-legged pivot, curtsy, stay and come, fetch, catch, passage, crossing his front legs, pedals to work, and the rear. As Lucas's video viewers reached hundreds of thousands on YouTube, local as well as international media rushed to feature Lucas on their TV screens and papers, as well as online. Lucas has been on NBC, CBS, ABC, CNN, and Inside Edition.
And finally, move over, Mr. Ed. We have found the smartest horse in the world.
Right here.
Oh.
You're looking at the world's smartest horse.
Start from the beginning. Where's your one? That's right.
His name is Lucas. He's 17 years old, and he can count up to five.
Where's a two? Good.
Even after we put the numbers in a different order, Lucas still counted them down.
Where's a four? Good.
Lucas has been in newspapers, forums, blogs, and newsletters around the globe, as well as the Associated Press and America Online.
I just think that horses like Lucas can really open the public's eye to what sort of potential a former racehorse has. And former racehorses have so much wind and heart and ability, they actually stay sound, even with old injuries, if you know how to manage them, have a good relationship with your veterinarian, take your time, be patient. They all have such a great future ahead of them. And that's what we're trying to promote, too, in our web series. And he, of course, is our poster boy.
The World Record Academy titled Lucas as the world's smartest horse. And now, Lucas has completed all of the requirements needed, pending final approval by Guinness World Records, to earn the record most numbers identified by a horse in 1 minute.
With a horse, it's all about the relationship between the owner and the horse, the trainer and the horse. Horses want to please. And when you look at Lucas and Karen together, Lucas can't take his eyes off of her. He follows her with his eyes, with his mind. He's waiting for her to tell him what to do. But he wants to do it for her. You know, he wants to please. He wants to learn himself. He's a horse that's looking to grow like a person. And the two of them, both Karen and Lucas, are growing together. You know, every day can be a new experience for them. And, you know, the sky's the limit. You know, I look forward to just to seeing the next world record that Lucas attempts and he achieves. Because it's there. It's just waiting. But it's going to happen.
Lucas was nominated for the 2010 Equine Vision Award, sponsored by Pfizer and American Horse Publications, and has been invited to attend events all over the country.
I'm dedicated to sharing Lucas's story as a tribute to hope and happiness, and to demonstrate the potential miracle of a second chance and love.
Good dry kiss.